What up, everybody? It's your boy CD back to you guys again with more crypto news. Now, before I get into the topic of today's video, if you guys could do me a favor and hit that like button, it's the easiest way for you to show your support. It takes less than a second and it puts me on a good side of the YT algorithms. So, this is a topic near and dear to my heart, as all of you may have gotten the message in the previous videos I've made. I have a serious disdain for the Internal Revenue Service, also known as the IRS, because in my personal opinion, unchecked taxation that the citizens have no control over what their money is doing and it's mandatory is literally theft. That's theft, if you ask me. And the fact that the IRS is struggling with cryptocurrency taxation and privacy enhancing tools or protocols that are being added is a blessing to my ears. It's a blessing. Not to say I'm doing it per se, but it's a blessing to hear that they're having it stuck to them. The IRS is laying the groundwork for a possible assault on privacy-enhancing crypto technologies. CI Cybercrime Unit challenges industry partners to explain where the crypto tracing community stands on privacy coins, layer 2 protocols, sidechains, and the Schnorr signature algorithm in a June 30th request for information. There are few investigative resources for tracing transactions that move across these privacy-enhancing vectors, the IRS said, noting a recent spike in illicit privacy coin use. Illicit. Yeah. The CI Cybercrimes program is working to get in front of this trend. The IRS singled out the Monero, Zcash, Dash, Grin, Komodo, Verge, and Horizon privacy coins, Plasma and Amise Go sidechains, and Lightning Radiant and Seller protocol networks, layer 2 networks. What's good for user privacy is bad for investigative efficacy. The IRS bemoaned the Bitcoin blockchain's apparent plans to integrate Schnorr signatures, writing that such a move will undercut IRS agents' current tracing techniques. The tax agency seeks estimates of how much it will cost to support this initiative, as well as return on investment estimates. Look, if you are helping the IRS steal from the American people or just the people of the world, you are a scumbag. I don't care what anybody says. You are scum. Look, we all know that we are looked at as cattle. The IRS is a foreign entity that just happens to set up shop over here and says that we're gonna run things as far as collecting money from people, which is ridiculous. The IRS is un-American, if you ask me. Across the world, maybe un-Chinese. Well, I think China, IRS fits right in China, but no. In America, no. I honestly feel like that is extremely un-American in the ideals that America was born out of. So my stance on the IRS is extremely strong. I actually have a song at the end of this that I'm gonna sh let you guys listen to that I actually discovered recently, and man, it makes me feel good every time I play it. But next article. Sun sets on offshore banking as assets worth $11 trillion uncovered. So, as you guys know, or if you don't know, in the early 1990s, maybe as early as the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, even the early 2000s, offshore banking was extremely prevalent among the wealthy. People would basically take their money overseas, open up bank accounts, and leave their money in those bank accounts. Most of these companies were not reporting to the home territory of said person. So that person could leave money in a tax, basically, sanctuary, a tax sanctuary. And there were no reporting laws or anything, so people could have their money in these sanctuaries, not being touched by any type of taxation. And they'd be living the good life as a result of it. Now, as of around 2017, they've started issuing mandatory reporting guidelines or laws or rules or whatever regulation, whatever you want to call it. So countries now have to report these holdings of cash towards the home, the country of origin of the money. And it really sucks, in my opinion, because it just goes to show you that we really have no privacy. Like, we really cannot save ourselves to a certain degree. It's just kind of sad when you see these things taking place. The Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, or the OECD, reported on Tuesday how automatic reporting in 2019 helped uncover $11 trillion worth of assets in offshore accounts. The result came as the Common Reporting Standard, or CRS, entered its third year of operation since its launch in 2017. Unlike many previous iterations, international tax reporting standards requires countries to automatically report activity in accounts held by foreign nationals to their respective country of origin. This solves issues deriving from request-based information sharing, which required active suspicion and investigation from the originating country. This is supported by over 100 countries across the globe, which seek to curtail tax evasion enabled by offshore bank accounts and regulatory arbitrage. Notably, the standard was adopted in 2017 by popular destinations like the Cayman Islands, the Seychelles, and many others. Since the introduction of CRS in 2017, the amount of assets that fell under scrutiny increased tenfold from 1.2 trillion to around, like the article said, about 11 trillion. So now they're also saying that cryptocurrency might fill the hole that these tax havens have basically left. And I honestly do believe that crypto is the way to go as far as opting out of the system, opting out of the BS, opting out of, not people not having you in their best interest. It's just opting out altogether of this system where you're continuously getting effed in the A. So, in my personal opinion, everybody, the IRS is not going to stop trying to restrict our freedoms, steal from us, destroy our future our legacy. Like, it's never going to stop. And all we can do is continue to do our best to opt out the system, study up on new ways to fight back, in my personal opinion, and even more so, ask for some clear legislation on the cryptocurrency space as far as taxes go, because it is completely unfair. As I told you guys earlier, like, maybe the IRS would have more success in, having people do, how can I put this? In having people not avoid paying taxes by, giving us some clear legislation that is completely fair to us, that makes actual sense, if you ask me. Like I stated earlier, possibly just a uniform tax for cryptocurrencies, or even just it comes in and it does what it does, and it comes out, and that's when you tax it, as far as converting it back to regular fiat. Because let's be real, mass adoption is not to the point where cryptos are just widely accepted like that in retail markets or retail stores. So it's just a matter of what game they want to play, because the people in the cryptocurrency space can't play hardball, as you guys have seen. They can play hardball, and they will continue to play hardball as these innovations keep stepping up. There's too many ways to fight back. So instead of trying to track people down, why don't you just simply make legislation that's completely fair to the people in the cryptocurrency space? You know what I'm saying? I'm pretty sure I understand that taxation is theft, but if you make it fair and reasonable, then I'm pretty sure more people will be okay and comfortable with saying, okay, well, I could give you guys 10%, 15%. You know what I'm saying? People would be comfortable with that to a certain degree, especially if it's the average law-abiding citizen. But when you have these laws and guidelines where everything's a taxable event and it kills you, your pockets like that, no, that's not fair. But anyway, guys, I have a song that I'm about to play for you guys. This has been your boy CG. Peace, I'm out.
Yeah, man, just feeling like I had something that I had to address about the IRS and all that, you feel me? Work hard on getting this money and shit. Trying to take all my money and shit. You feel me? So I had to let them know I might have to skip off. You feel me? Hop on the jet, be off.
I can't fuck with the
IRS. Give a fuck about the IRS. They just mad cause I'm riding on jets. They just mad cause I'm riding on jets. I can't fuck with the IRS. Give a fuck about the IRS. But if the IRS hear this song, then I fuck with the IRS. I can't fuck with the IRS. Are they mad cause I'm riding on jets?
Are they mad?
I got diamonds on my neck.
Are they mad
cause I'm young and I'm flex?
Are they mad?
These niggas actors, they young and I'm restless. Every time I got that heat like it's Texas.
And
you know I'm on the map like a GPS is. I don't even ask for directions. I be skating, I'm in the future like the Matrix. It's trace bases, I'm out the way, I'm too evasive. They try to copy, I paint the picture and they trace it. I be skating, I'm 360 like a tray flip. If you want some of my skate, take my old skate. I'm too fresh and I'm too clean, but ain't no Colgate. Your best shit not even close to my throwaways. Go away, like you really gotta go away. Three time, one man army, yeah I'm OMA. If he talking about a bag, then I'm on my way. Bitch be asking all them questions like a Q&A. I'm a real one, it's written in my DNA. Three time, I'm in the mountains with my sensei. Practicing my karate in my MMA. Trace bases, what do you wanna do today? Same thing that we do every day, get to this cake. Okay. I be flying like a plane. All they do is complain. Why they always be hating? Why they always be hating? What did I do to deserve this? What did I do to deserve this? What did I do to deserve this? Why they always be hating on the kid? Why they always be hating on the kid? I be out in public, but you never even know when you see. Yeah, you know when you see. When you see me, yeah, you know it's him. Oh yeah, the IRS, you a bitch. I can't fuck with the IRS. Give a fuck about the IRS. They just mad cause I'm riding on jets. They just mad cause I'm riding on jets. I can't fuck with the IRS. Give a fuck about the IRS. But if the IRS hit his song, then I fuck with the IRS. They just mad cause I'm riding on jets. They just mad cause I'm riding on jets. I can't fuck with the IRS. Give a fuck about the IRS. But if the IRS hit its song, then I fuck with the IRS.